Well, how about this? August is peak leopard shark season, and we've got Molly Beth Samoka from the Birch Aquarium at Scripps here to tell us all about it. This is one of my favorite seasons because you really got to just grab that stand-up paddleboard, get out there, and see the leopard sharks. So have we seen any yet?
Yes, actually, the season for leopard sharks is kind of expanding. We're seeing those conditions where they like to aggregate locally, actually bleed into the sort of April and May months as well.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. Do we know why?
Well, like we've noticed all across the coast, the coastlines are changing. We're seeing warmer waters kind of infiltrate our normal habitats, and that's sort of what the leopard sharks tend to aggregate around. So as we see that, we might actually have more and more leopard sharks aggregating by our coastlines.
Yeah, they are attracted to the warmer water. Is there a reason why? I know why, but I'm going to let you answer for everybody at home.
Yeah, so scientists actually have found that 97% of the aggregate of leopard sharks in La Jolla tend to be pregnant females. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of a mommy club, a mommy party. And this might be because they are following warmer water trends. Their metabolism is going to be based on their external environment. And so having those warmer waters might actually help to support their gestation. And so they're going to want to hang out when those calm, warmer waters are available to them.
There's two kinds of people out there. There's one that think it's really, really cool and we want to see the sharks, and then there's others that are terrified and they think these sharks are really scary. Can you kind of ease any fears for people that are worried about seeing these sharks? There are days, and there have been seasons here in San Diego, where if you get an overhead view, there are clumps of sharks in the water, and this could be really scary for a visitor or someone who doesn't know about them.
Yeah, actually, if you're afraid of sharks, you and leopard sharks have that in common. They too are actually afraid of larger sharks themselves, because they themselves are prey. They're actually not very big. I actually brought a jaw of a leopard shark with me, so you can see how small they are. And the teeny, teeny, tiny teeth that line the inside. Can you see it in there?
I can. I want to touch them.
Oh, they are still sharp.
Yeah.
But probably no more than like a kitten, right?
Right. So my question to you is, why don't they want to bite us, or why are they not kind of so worried as this species of shark?
Yeah, they've evolved to eat a lot of animals that we might also like to eat, like shellfish and things. So they might like a nice crab or clam or squid that swims by, but they themselves aren't going to be big enough or, you know, going after anything much larger than what they can fit inside their tiny mouths. If you were to maybe harass them or be up in their business, I'm sure they would not hesitate to defend themselves as a last resort, but I've actually never heard of that happening with leopard sharks. But we do want to respect them and make sure that we give them the space they need. They're going to want to avoid us at all costs, along with the sea lions and seals that also predate on them.
We're not their prey.
Right.
They're just hanging around doing their thing, and they're not big hunters, right? So when they eat the things that are just kind of hanging around them, that's their food. They're not big hunters, and so that's why we don't need to be as worried about them. Where can people find them? Because I know there's special spots where they kind of hang out around La Jolla, where you say, okay, if you want to see the leopard sharks, go over to this special spot.
Yeah, you could encounter a leopard shark anytime that you're swimming along the coast of California, all the way up to Oregon and down into Baja, Mexico, but something I find very endearing about leopard sharks is they tend to find neighborhoods that they hang out in, and it tends to be where they themselves hatched. And so we have aggregate of leopard sharks that we see aggregating in the in front of the Marine Room restaurant and the La Jolla Shores Hotel, which is in the Matalahui State Marine Reserve between Scripps Pier and La Jolla Cove.
Okay.
And so that is where you see that drone footage of hundreds of leopard sharks aggregating when you have those nice calm conditions. And that's likely because of the branches of the canyon that come up, and it actually makes certain areas of that coastline good for surfing, and then certain areas better for the leopards.
And for swimming, yeah, for all of us. So before we go back to break really quick, you have some toys next to you. And for people who want to see leopard sharks, they can actually see them at
If you don't want to brave the ocean on a paddleboard or with your snorkel equipment, you can come to Shark Summer at Birch Aquarium, where we are celebrating all of our shark and ray friends. And actually, our leopard sharks are getting their physicals, their annual physicals, this morning
Oh, fun.
Now.
Okay.
But I did bring our animal care team gave me some of the toys that they often will offer the different sharks at the aquarium. So they might put like a little crab or some pieces of mackerel in here, and the sharks have to come and kind of, you know, create that suction to get it out.
Cat toys and shark toys look very similar.
Yeah, and our sharks are actually trained to come up to a special target disc. So they know if they come on up and boop that with their nose, that's when they're going to get their nice special treat for the day.
Smart, too. Very cool. Molly, thank you so much for coming out. We're going to put the information if you want to go see the sharks in the water, or if you want to see them at the aquarium. You've got options with that Shark Summer. We're going to put it on Fox5SanDiego.com. All you have to do is click on that Scene On tab. We'll be right back.